Hello everyone, and welcome to this mini tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to recreate this product promotional animation using Linearity Move. Let's start by creating a new file. Go to File, New. Select a resolution as square and leave the frame rate as 30 FPS. Click Confirm. We're going to import in our scene. So go to New Scene, click Import, and select the file provided called productpromoanimation.curve. Click Open. In the Import panel, you will see as many artboards as there are on your curve file, which in this case is this many. We're going to create two scenes using the Import panel. Select all the artboards with white background. You can select multiple artboards by holding Shift while you do so. Now select and drag them onto the scene builder line. This way we've created our first scene, called Scene 1. Now select all the artboards with the blue background. Hold Shift to select multiple artboards. Now drag and drop them next to the first scene. And this way we've created the second scene, called Scene 2. Click Import. Let's preview our first import. What we just looked at is the result of what we call auto-animation. Linearity Move recognize that objects are changing states between one artboard to the other and creates automatically a transition from one state to the other. To better understand how auto-animation works, let's shift our attention to curve. This is the curve file of our project. You will see that every artboard contains all the same elements with the same name. Card 1 is called Card 1 in the first artboard and also in the second artboard. The only thing that's changed is its position. The same goes for the text. Now it's moved to the left, and the other card are following to the center of the artboard. As long as all your elements are present on every artboard, and all the elements have the same name, Linearity Move is going to be able to identify those elements and create automatic transition between one artboard to the other. Let's go back to our Move project. It's time to make some tweaks to this animation and make the transitions from one scene to the other smoother. The first thing we want to do is to change the transition from Scene 1 to Scene 2. Click the bolt icon here in the middle, and then go to the right of your workspace into the animation panel. Here, the type of animation is already set to instant. We want to change that. Click the drop-down menu and select Push. You can change the direction of the push, but bottom to top is what we need at the moment. The timing is set as linear, but we want it to have a bit of a smoother effect. So click the drop-down menu and select Natural. The duration of the transition is set to half a second. We want to make it slightly longer. 1 second will do. Let's preview the transition. To make the transition even more seamless, we can add some elements to Scene 1 before it changes to Scene 2. To edit Scene 1, double-click on the scene. You will see here that we have all our elements laid out on the left in the layer panel. Let's switch our workspace to design mode. In the toolbar, select the shape tool, and we're going to create an oval. Hold Shift while you click and drag to create a perfect circle. The circle is white and we cannot really see it. So let's go to Style, Fill, and with the color picker, select the blue of the text. Perfect. I'll position it to the center of the Canva using the alignment settings here at the top. I want the circle to start from the bottom and grow bigger and cover the entire Canva. Let's position it to its starting point. To drag the circle down, hold Shift so it will follow a straight line. Now let's switch to animate mode. Any changes we're going to do from now on will create a transition on the timeline. Drag the playhead to the end of your transition. Now we can reposition the circle to the center of the Canva. To make sure it's at the center, you can still use the alignment tools here at the top. We also want to change the size of the circle, so use the bounding box. Hold Shift and Option while you enlarge it. And now the circle is covering the entire Canva. The animation right now is too slow, and the circle is covering all our other objects. The first thing we want to do is to make it shorter. Grab the handles of the animation bar to change the duration of the animation. And then in the layer panel, click and drag the layer to the bottom of the list. We want the animation to roughly happen at the end of our animation, so we need the time to be a bit longer. Click the scene. And then on the right, go to animation. Here we can change the duration of the scene. Let's add a second to it. And now we're going to drag the animation bar and position it roughly here. Let's preview our transition from the main scene panel. Perfect. Very seamless. I also noticed that the transition in animation in the scene 2 are too slow. Double-click scene 2 to start editing. To make the transition shorter, we can select these handles on the animation bars like we did before. If we want to change the duration of the entire scene, we can change the position of the handles directly on the scene animation bar. As I drag them around, all the handles that are aligned to this one will change. This will do. Now it's time to export our animation. Go to File, Export, and here we can preview one last time our animation. Thank you for joining me today. I'll see you in the next tutorial.